A very good o'clock, dear students. Today we'll continue our discussion over chapter 19, that is natural regions of the world, and we'll study about other region, that is tropical monsoon climatic region. Okay, so this word I think is very known to you. We also experience this kind of climate itself in India, right? And we have discussed enough about it, that what are the causes of monsoon climate, how it is related with the seasonal reversal of the wind, what is the direction of wind from where they are originating, and whatever is the phenomena during the monsoon in India. Okay, yeah, so let us see about the location of the countries which are experiencing monsoon climate. What are the areas, what is the temperature, precipitation, basically all the features of the monsoon climate. So it's generally related to those areas which register complete seasonal reversal of wind direction, as we know that there is a complete reversal of the direction of winds in the monsoon climate. That is, during summer the winds blow from southwest to northeast, and towards the winters the winds blow from northwest to southeast. Okay, so basically there is a complete reversal in the direction of the winds, and this monsoon climate is found in the zone extending between 5 degree and 30 degree latitude. Okay, what is the extent? That is 5 degree and 30 degree latitude from both south and from either side of the equator, that is north and south. And in fact this zone comes under the domain of trade winds belt. Okay, बिकॉज द रिवर्सल ऑफ डायरेक्शन जो होता है, जो सीजनल शिफ्ट होता है ट्रेड विंड्स का, उसकी वजह से होता है. ओके, एंड द सीजनल शिफ्ट इन द ट्रेड विंड इज ड्यू टू शिफ्ट इन द पोजिशन ऑफ सन नॉर्थवर्ड एंड साउथवर्ड. ओके, ऑन शोर विंड्स ब्लो फॉर 6 months, एज आई टोल्ड यू इन द समर द विंड्स ब्लो फ्रॉम सी टू लैंड, दैट इज ऑन शोर विंड्स. ओके, एंड इन द विंटर्स द डायरेक्शन इज कम्प्लीटली रिवर्स एंड द विंड ब्लो फ्रॉम लैंड टू सी, दैट इज ऑफ शोर विंड्स. ओके, सो वट आर द एरियाज ऑफ दिस क्लाइमेट? बेसिकली एरियाज ऑफ मॉनसून क्लाइमेट आर साउथ एंड साउथ ईस्ट एशिया. ओके, यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड इन 8th class 2 दैट दीज एरियाज आर साउथ एंड साउथ ईस्ट एशिया, दैट रिसीव मॉनसून फ्रॉम द साउथ वेस्ट मॉनसून विंड्स. ओके, सो दिस इंक्लूड कंट्रीज ऑफ इंडिया, पाकिस्तान, बांग्लादेश, म्यांमार, थाईलैंड, वियतनाम, फिलीपींस, साउथ चाइना एंड एशिया, साउथ ईस्ट अफ्रीका, गुएना कोस्ट ऑफ वेस्ट अफ्रीका, सेंट्रल अमेरिका एंड अदर्स. ओके, नाउ टेम्परेचर इफ यू टॉक अबाउट, थ्रू मीन एनुअल टेम्परेचर इज फेयरली हाई बिकॉज इट लाइंग इन द ट्रॉपिकल रीजन. ओके, सो द मीन एवरेज टेम्परेचर इज हाई, बट समर एंड विंटर सीजन शार्पली differentiate due to northward and southward movement of the sun. Okay, since this is tropical region, so due to the shift of the sun from in north or south, either according to the season, there are changes in the temperature range, annual temperature range. Okay, the summer temperature varies from 27 to 30 degrees Celsius in the coastal areas and 35 to 38 in the interior areas. Okay, that is also a factor, as we know that continental climate has a greater temperature range as compared to the coastal areas. Okay, and in the winter the temperature in the coastal regions is 22 to 25 degrees Celsius, that is a moderate temperature, whereas it falls in the interior parts of the country, that remains from 15 to 18 degrees Celsius respectively. Okay, so temperature means in the summer season the temperature varies from 27 to 38 degrees Celsius, okay, depending upon coastal and interior areas, and in the winters the temperature varies from 25 to 15 to 25 degree Celsius. Okay, there are three main seasons in a year in Indian subcontinent and surrounding monsoonal areas. Three kind of seasons can be clearly demarcated, right? First is dry warm summer season, that is from March to June, basically summer season. Second is humid warm summer season, that we also call the rainy season, monsoon season, right? That is July to October. And third is dry winter season, that is from November to February. Okay, these three seasons can be clearly demarcated. Then what is precipitation means the rainfall, the amount of rainfall received in the country. Since we are talking about monsoonal region, so abundant rainfall is received in the country, right? But it's a seasonal rainfall. Okay, so most of the annual rainfall through cyclonic and orographic types of rain is received from the monsoon. Two types of rains are there. There's cyclonic monsoon, cyclonic rain, and also the conventional rain, that orographic rain. Okay, cyclonic and orographic, not conventional. Conventional is received in the equatorial region, that is due to extreme heating of a place, but we receive the orographic rainfall, okay? That is western ghats, when southwest monsoon strike the western ghat, then they rise upward and winds shed their moisture. So that is the orographic rainfall, okay? In cyclonic rainfall, when there is a depression in the Bay of Bengal, then the winds are attracted towards that area from the inland of the country, okay? So basically these two types of rainfall are experienced, and on an average the annual rainfall is around 1500 mm, that is 150 cm around, okay? But there is a great variation. Some areas in India receive high rainfall, like Meghalaya, okay, Mausinram, Cherrapunji, they receive huge rainfall in the country, about 50 cm. But some areas receive very less rainfall, like Rajasthan, okay, that is 25 cm around rainfall, okay? So these regions, so there is a regional variation, okay? Most of the annual monsoon rainfall is received through moisture-laden southwest monsoon wind. Most of the monsoonal rainfall is received from southwest monsoon, okay, which come from the ocean surface, okay? Southwest monsoon come from ocean towards land, okay? It comes from Indian Ocean. Some parts of Indian subcontinent, like eastern coast of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, receive much rainfall during winter. As I told you, there is a complete reversal of direction in the monsoon winds in winter. Then the eastern coast of the country receives rainfall during winter season. We have discussed it enough, okay, that Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh receive rainfall during winter season, that is from the retreating monsoon winds, okay? Variability of rainfall in terms of amount and duration is the characteristic feature of monsoon climate. As we studied ki monsoon pattern is not fixed. Then what about natural vegetation? Number of plant species is far less than monsoon climate as compared to the equatorial climate, because equatorial climate receive abundant of rainfall on a daily basis, right? So there is a huge growth, a luxuriant growth of vegetation. But as compared to monsoonal climate, there is a seasonal rainfall that is too variably divided, okay? So there is a less number of vegetation here, okay? Height of the trees is also low, that is between 12 to 30 meter. And important species of trees include sal, teak, bamboo, mahua, jamun, neem, shisham, etc. Okay. The tropical and subtropical monsoon deciduous forest are under threat. Also, the tropical and subtropical monsoon forest are diminishing day by day because they are being destroyed rapidly through forest fires and overutilization of forest resources. Okay. Now let's talk about human adaptation and monsoon region. How people live in the monsoon region. So the landscape, animal, plant life, entire agriculture calendar and the life of the people, including their festivities, revolve around the phenomenon of arrival and departure of monsoon. We have also studied that monsoon has so much importance in India or adjoining countries mein, that in one or the other form, people's livelihood, unke festivities or unke life, agricultural calendar, yani kaun se season mein kaun se crop karna hai, all things are revolving around the arrival, timely arrival and departure of the monsoon, okay, and the amount of rainfall received. Most of people living in areas are farmers, okay, because it has adequate rainfall and good soil too. So their major crops is rice, which is staple food for millions of Asians. Since this monsoon is experienced in Asian continent, okay, so basically staple food of people here is rice. Mainly they grow rice. It's most often an irrigate to its growth important crop, okay? It means it's totally dependent upon water. Each year an adequate food supply for much of South and Southeast Asia depend upon arrival and departure of monsoon, because it's an important staple food, okay? So people, for their fulfillment of demand, depend upon monsoon, okay? The difference between famine and survival for many people in these regions is very much associated with the climate, okay? So to prevent the famine conditions or drought conditions, monsoon is very important. India has two cropping season, monsoon India, that is Rabi and Kharif, we all know, okay? Rabi is towards winter and Kharif is towards summer, okay? Rabi crops are sown in winter from October to December, harvested in summer. Some of them are wheat, barley, peas, gram and mustard, okay? Then Kharif season, it's onset of monsoon in different parts of the country and harvested in September and October. And crops grown here are that require lot amount of water, like paddy, that is rice, maize, jowar, bajra, tur, moong, urad, cotton, jute, groundnut and soybean, all these, okay? Then Dhangars of Maharashtra, there are tribe, Golas, Kurmas, Kurubas, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Raikas of Rajasthan are important pastoral communities of monsoon India. Pastoral means those who rear animals, okay? They have a cycle of seasonal movement revolving around the monsoon. Means they revolve around the country depending upon the monsoon season. Most of them are shepherds. Shepherds means who rear the sheep. Okay, some are blanket weavers. So basically if they rear sheep, they have wool. So they weave the blankets. Still others are buffalo herders. Some have buffaloes. Due to the availability of fodder and dhangar, community stays in the semi-arid central plateau of Maharashtra. Okay. During monsoon, but they move towards Konkan during dry days in search of food and fodder. So according to the season, they shift their location. The Golas herds cattle, whereas the Kurumans and Kurubas rear sheep and goat. Okay, so there's a difference in the variety of the livestock that they rear, and their movement is also governed by the arrival and departure of monsoon. In the Himalayan region, especially in the areas of northeast Himalaya, the tribe in general have adopted jhum or shifting cultivation. In the northeast India, still many tribes are there who practice jhum cultivation, that is shifting cultivation. Okay, now that's all about the monsoonal climate. We'll discuss the Mediterranean region in another video. Thank you.